August 8, 2016. Time is about 7:30 PM. The dog, the poodle, 1 year old, with tick fever, had gone home with medication, as the owner prefers the dog to be home. These are the tests done for checking the other four pathogens. They were negative. The test is Cani V-4. And as you can see, these are the explanation of the tests. The Babesia blood smear has been done and will show many Babesia canis in red blood cells. This will be in another slide, another video. Now, I do a summary of the history of the dog. Now, the dog went to vet one because the owner wanted to go somewhere near his home on the 23rd and 30th of March 2016. As you can see, even on 23rd, the red blood cells, hemoglobin and platelets were low. At that time, the complaint was vomiting and restlessness, so the vet gave anti-gastric injection and PrEP. Probably the dog had recovered, but then on 30th the dog had to go back again because it wasn't fully recovered, and the blood test done by vet one was still the same: low red cell count, low hemoglobin, and these are the things, findings of vet one. You can see the platelets were low as well on 23rd and 30th. The only thing was, at the time, on the second visit, 30th, the dog was prescribed doxycycline, but there was no blood smear done for Babesia. So on the 7th of April, the father brought the dog here for treatment because the dog was still lethargic. It did eat, but one small can of food. There's no appetite, as you can see. The blood test was done, shows that all the hemoglobin red blood cells were low and the platelets was much lower at 10. Now, the MCHC show that there's a regenerative anemia. That means the bone marrow is producing red blood cells, but much has been destroyed by the Babesia parasites, as you can see from the smear in another video. So this is the latest situation with this poodle that has gone home and has been given the drips, vitamin K, one iron injection, and antibiotics. Has the white cell count was high at 21.4. Normally it's 9 to 6 to 17. Neutrophils were high at 80%, nearly 81%. Absolutes was high as well. This was the latest finding at Toa Payoh Vets. So antibiotics were given together with 2 bottles of drips, Hartman, amino acids, vitamins, and iron injections subcutaneously. So we have to wait till tomorrow and the next few days to see whether the dog has recovered from Babesia cyst. Now this test does not check for Babesia, so you need to do the blood smear to test for it. This fourth test doesn't tell you there is no Babesia cyst, and in this case the main problem was Babesia, and together the clinical signs of low red blood cell, low hemoglobin, and low platelets, one must suspect tick fever as the first diagnosis and give the treatment. Normally it is Imizol, which I just given yesterday. And if you see the video, you see the video today, yesterday was 7, today is 8. You see the dogs appear to have the pink gums and pink tongue. As this afternoon I had taken a video, and signs are good with regenerative anemia at 87. For MCH and MCV at 28. So this shows that the prognosis may be good for this 1-year-old poodle, according to Dr. Daniel. Other than that, we have to wait and see, because the platelets are drastically low at minus 10, less than 10. That was before the Imizol injection, but the blood smear at that time showed Babesia positive. Queen's Vet, Toa Payoh Vets, April 8, 2016, 6 p.m. Tick fever in a 1-year-old poodle with pale gums and tongue.